What is actually in these vapes?
Nothing good, apparently. A new Queensland study breaking down the contents of these poisonous pacifiers is painting a pretty bleak picture.
The results are shocking. They are confronting. Huge amounts of nicotine in vapes being sold as nicotine-free.
Tests on 17 lolly flavours like Summer Breeze and Watermelon Ice found things like formaldehyde, the chemical used to preserve dead bodies, arsenic and zinc, as well as a whole periodic table of heavy metals.
Chemicals used in the production of paint, in pharmaceuticals, in the cleaning of steel, chemicals used in paint stripper, nail polish remover, and even in rat poison. One chemical alone, formaldehyde, is a known type 1 human carcinogen.
And the potential health implications are frightening.
These are highly toxic chemicals that affect the brain, increase the risk of chronic disease, including many types of cancers, but can even affect your ability to reproduce.
But despite the warnings, a third of under 30s have had the odd puff, while 14% are invested vapers.
I am currently trying to stop just because I'm becoming a bit more aware that it's really not good for you.
I get disgusted seeing the vape stores all over the place.
I don't know about inhaling arsenic as much as if you pop it in your husband's cup of tea to get rid of him, but I probably expect that it is just as dangerous to inhale it.
Nicotine vapes are already illegal in Australia without a doctor's prescription. And a crackdown announced this month will see recreational use outlawed, as well as a ban on importing the non-pharmaceutical varieties and tighter restrictions on flavours and packaging.
One teaspoon alone of e-cigarette liquid contains as much nicotine as six packets of cigarettes.
So will these grave new warnings be enough to lift the haze on this new era of addiction?
After watching that, I'm slightly concerned about vaping. I'm a bit more concerned about that woman who's clearly going to murder her.
No, we should check, right?
We should track her down and follow her movements.
I know. She looked happy that maybe she could just buy him a vape.
Oh, yeah.
She was having some
ideas.
But this
is crazy, right?
I can't believe that arsenic, formaldehyde, like these chemicals are in vapes. And I think the most concerning part is that it is young people predominantly who are having them, and they've almost been marketed as a safer or more socially acceptable option to cigarettes.
Yeah, and I also feel like our literacy in terms of the ingredients list, I feel like when we were growing up, it was like you looked at every single thing, we're like, how much sugar does this have in this?
Yeah.
Whereas now it's like the vape cartridges themselves have absolutely nothing on it other than like fun cartoon, like colourful cartoons.
And cigarettes, even the packaging, I mean, the images are really confronting, and you've got all this text and warnings, and vapes have come along with absolutely nothing.
They should have to put photos of that woman's future-to-be-murdered husband on the
phone. I know, remember
to discourage.
Whatever it's called.